Today, in recognition of the upcoming Veterans Day, the Bishop School honors Colonel Jerry Coleman, a Marine, a baseball teammate, and as many of you know him, the voice of the San Diego Padres.
Hi everybody, Jerry Coleman here, Qualcomm Stadium, San Diego, California, the New York Yankees, San Diego Padres, Game 4 of the 1998 World Series.
That's your real Mr. Padre, Jerry Coleman. And I love Jerry because Jerry was always honest with me when I first came up. I used to pick his brain and ask him about stuff. And he was always gracious with his time to help me understand stuff. And again, you're talking about a guy who, you know, loves the game, believes it should be played the right way. And Jerry really helped me understand the right way.
Amazing man, Jerry. I really couldn't respect anybody more than you and everything you've accomplished.
Always one of the great gentlemen of the game. And I was always so happy that he won the Ford C. Frick Award for the broadcasters at the Hall of Fame. But also a true American hero, two different wars. And called right out of the prime of his baseball career into a second war. And he went uncomplaining and doesn't complain about it to this day. But it may well have cut short his baseball career. It certainly didn't help it any. So Jerry Coleman, for me, classed up the whole Hall of Fame as well as the Ford C. Frick Award when he went in. And for that, I'm always going to be eternally grateful.
Born in San Jose, California, Gerald Francis Coleman signed with the New York Yankees minor league system after high school at the age of 17. This was a time when country came first, when Americans set aside victory for everything, and baseball was no different. Where some players walked away from one uniform to another. So once Coleman turned 18, he postponed his baseball career and joined the Marine Corps. In April 1944, Coleman was commissioned as second lieutenant and departed to Guadalcanal. Coleman flew 57 combat missions in the SBD Dauntless Dive Bomber throughout campaigns involving Guadalcanal, the Solomon Islands, and the Philippines. During this time, Coleman would earn 2 Distinguished Flying Crosses and 7 Air Medals. In 1946, Coleman resumed his baseball career, and in 1949, the graceful fielding second baseman became the starter for the Yankees. Coleman began a run that may not be matched by anyone today. In his 9 years as a Yankee second baseman, Coleman played in 6 World Series and won 8 division titles. Coleman earned Rookie of the Year honors in 1949, played in the 1950 All-Star Game, and was named the 1950 World Series MVP. Then in May of 1952, with the Korean War taking place, Coleman unselfishly returned to active duty for combat service. During this time, Coleman flew 63 missions, earning 6 more air medals, 13 total, the Korean Service Medal with 2 stars, and the United Nations Service Medal. In 1953, he was transferred back to the United States, where he would once again suit up with the Yankees as their starting second baseman until he retired in 1957. Coleman would remain in the Marine Corps Reserves until he retired as a lieutenant colonel in 1964. After leaving the baseball playing field, Coleman joined the broadcast booth with stops in New York and California with the San Diego Padres. In 2005, Jerry Coleman was selected into the National Baseball Hall of Fame as the Ford C. Frick Award recipient as an announcer. This past summer, the Padres honored him during a Jerry Coleman Day and unveiled a statue in his honor.
No athlete in American sport has ever voluntarily left his sport, not once, but twice, to enlist and fight against his country's enemies overseas.
For your leadership, for your contributions, and for your sacrifices for our country, from all of us at the Bishop School, we thank you, Colonel Jerry Coleman.